Morning, Salim. Yes, I will get your breakfast now.
Swinging in the backyard, pull up in your fast car, listening. Open up a beer, take it over here and play a video game. I'm in his favorite sundress, watching me get undressed, take that body downtown. I say you're the bestest, leaning for a big kiss, put his favorite perfume on, go play a video game.
Yeah, hiya. Can I speak to the producer of Morning Focus, please?
What are you doing?
I'm just cancelling, changed my mind.
Oh, no, 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 hang up!
Yeah.
Oh, no! Thought you were really looking forward to it.
Yeah, I was, but I've been thinking about my results. And I've been thinking about us.
What about us?
I've been neglecting you. Not to mention my work. I don't need any more distractions.
Oh, come on, it's only an hour or so.
Exactly, so it doesn't matter, does it?
No, think about it. Yeah, it's Diversity Week. It's a real chance to make a difference. Dispel some prejudices.
Sleep well.
Yes, sir.
Don't forget, folks, as part of Diversity Week, Rhonda Stahl's guest will be lesbian blogger One Frank Female, whose online posts are...
Eggs all right?
Very nice.
I have to go to the doctor today. I did tell you. Get the stitches out.
Fine. You know I worry about you when you're out. Just be careful. Better be going then. Aren't you forgetting something? You better not be late back, or else you spend another night in the shed.
What are you up to?
Oh, just doing some questions for the nanny interviews.
Don't hire anyone till I've spoken to them as well, okay?
Okay.
Let me see. What infant cognitive techniques do you intend to use? What are the four components of the attachment theory?
What's wrong?
Are you serious? We're hiring a nanny, not a psychiatrist.
I just want what's best for our son.
Well, so do I. But he doesn't need a medical expert. Poor kid's already got two doctors for parents.
Oh, I'm not taking any chances.
He just needs somebody who's caring and maternal.
He also needs someone who'll ensure he'll get the right level of stimulation.
Yeah, I know that.
The early years are crucial to his development. We can't just hire anyone.
Well, if no one without your expertise will do, maybe you shouldn't be going back to work just yet.
Shelley, how are you?
I'm fine. How's retirement? Are you living it up?
Not exactly.
Must be nice, though, being a lady of leisure.
Hardly.
Well, you take a seat and we'll get those stitches out.
Thank you.
Okay, let's have a look. Oh, how did you get those bruises?
It was when I cut my hand. I fell on some broken glass in the garden.
Mm, nasty.
I swear, the older I get, the clumsier I get.
You must be Freya Wilson.
Oh,
I'm Rhonda.
Hello, my love. Nice to meet you.
Just to let you know, the first part of the show will be a phone-in. You okay with that?
Yes.
Nothing to worry about. It'll just be a few questions about what it's like to be a lesbian.
Ah.
Oh, problem?
Yeah, I'm bisexual.
What?
I thought you guys knew.
Well, for the purposes of the interview, if you could just not mention that.
No.
You've been trailed as a lesbian, so we're going to look pretty stupid now if we contradict that.
So you want me to lie?
Well, you should have told us before.
Oh, well, you should have maybe done a little bit more research, seeing as it's quite clear on my blog.
Sorry, I didn't mean to be rude. It's just there's quite a lot riding on this interview.
How do you mean?
My boss is looking for any excuse to get rid of me. I just can't screw this up. Ah, God, I feel like such an idiot. I don't know what to do.
Look, it's okay. Look, I obviously, I'm not keen on this, but I can avoid talking about myself too much. We can keep it general.
Thank you. That would be fantastic. You are a lifesaver. Right. I'll set up and I'll send someone to get you shortly.
Do you not want to ask me any questions?
So, are you still in touch with your old colleagues?
Not since leaving, no.
Oh, that's a shame.
Oh, to be honest, Jerry, I really miss working. Oh, I'm just stuck in the house most days.
I've got a meeting at St. Phil's this morning. I could give you a lift. You could pop in and say hello to a few people.
Oh, I'd like that. But I'd need to ask Salim.
Okay.
Well, what I mean is I don't like to leave him alone for too long. He had a stroke recently.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know that.
Well, it was a minor one. He's almost better. I'll sort something out. I'd love to go.
Okay, well, I'll pick you up at about 10. Any problems, just give me a call.
Well, thank you, Cherry.
See you later.
I was as quick as I could. It's all sorted, see? Have you been all right?
Fine. I'll be back on my feet in no time.
Good. The hospital phoned to ask me to pick up a few things from my locker.
What things?
Oh, just bits and bobs, you know.
No, I don't.
My brush mug.
You brought your mug home weeks ago.
Did I? Oh, it must be some other little thing.
You think I'm an idiot? Tell me the truth. Now!
Just wanted to see some of my work colleagues. I'm so sorry. The doctor told you that you should rest, Salim.
On your knees.
No.
On your knees.
Please, Salim, no.
Now! You know what happens to liars? You've only brought this on yourself.
No. Salim? Salim? Are you all right? Ambulance, please. I'm sorry. False alarm.
Your daddy has got this for brains. He doesn't know what he's talking about. I'm glad you agree. You and I will find a nanny who is just right. And remember, if there's any that you particularly like, just give me that little cheeky smile of yours. And if there's any that you particularly hate, just... well, make some other noise. Perfect.
I'm going to visit my work colleagues. You have a problem with that? I thought not. I won't be long.
Well, of course, we all like to think we live in a liberal society, but you must have encountered people who view you as some kind of degenerate or pervert.
No, not really.
The only reason I ask is because we've already had some fairly negative texts this morning. Salim from Leatherbridge says that people like you are abnormal and disgusting. How would you answer that?
I'm not sure that really deserves an answer, Salim.
So what are you saying, that people aren't entitled to their own opinion?
No, of course I'm not saying that.
After all, isn't that what diversity is all about? I would assume, with you being part of a minority, you would respect that.
And I do. You're twisting what I'm saying. What I mean is...
Time for another caller. We have Paul from Sutton Vale on the line.
I just wanted to ask, when did you come out to your parents?
Well, Paul. I don't really have a typical coming-out story, if there is such a thing. What I mean is, I never had any desire to confess anything to my parents because all of my first relationships were with boys.
Boys?
You were obviously in denial.
No, that's not
and
it.
And Denial Twist by the White Stripes just happens to be our first track. We'll be right back. If you think that a kiss is on the lips, come on, you got it all wrong, man. And if you think that our dance was all in the hips, oh well, then do the twist. If you think holding hands is all in the fingers, grab hold of the soul where the memory lingers, and make sure to never do it with a singer, cause I'll tell everyone in the world what he was thinking about the girl. Yeah, what he's thinking about the girl. Oh, a lot of people get confused and they're what's it really like being part of a minority?
Well, you see, I don't see it like that. We are all somewhere along the sexual spectrum.
Are we? I thought most people were at either end. I mean, I like men and you like women.
Anna, sorry, I tried to stop her.
Hiya, I'm Amanda.
This is my partner.
Anna, I'm going to do the interview with her.
Well, as you just heard, folks, we seem to have an unexpected guest.
Thought you could do with the support.
So, keep your texts coming in and the lesbians from Leatherbridge will try and answer all your questions.
Hi, Nadra. You okay?
Just a bit emotional coming back here.
Have you seen everyone?
Yes, and all the newborns.
Oh.
I think it's the babies that I miss the most.
Have you had children of your own?
Yes, I did. A girl. I need to get back home. Salim is...
Well, I can give you a lift if you just give me...
There's no need. I thank you, though, for the lift earlier. I appreciate it.
So, am I right in thinking your blog now has nearly 2,000 followers?
Yeah. Can't quite believe it.
Well, a recent article from the online mag Lost Voice says your blog is witty, funky, and with a finger firmly on the pulse. You're fast becoming Leatherbridge's most famous lesbian.
Hold on. You need to get your facts straight.
Okay, moving on.
No. Not moving on. We need to sort this out. You know, it's totally clear from Freya's blog that she's bisexual. And you would know that if you'd bothered to read it.
I have actually read it.
Look, I'm really sorry to any listeners who've been misled this morning. I promise you that I don't make a habit of hiding my sexuality. And it's a real shame that we just can't talk about me being bi.
Well, actually, I was just about to move on to that very subject. Right after this song.
People are strange when you're a stranger. Faces look ugly when you're alone. Women seem wicked when you're unwanted. Streets are uneven when you're down.
So, recent studies in childcare have identified that learning should be contextual, cultural, and respectful of children's competencies. How would you put this into practice?
No one remembers your name.
Your CV is very impressive. Perhaps you'd like to interact with Joe a little. Pick him up a bit, maybe.
Had a lovely time. Saw all my old work colleagues. I even held one of the babies. You've only brought this on yourself. Not like you. Not like you. Not like you.
Hmm.
Murderer.
Well, since we're now moving on to the subject of bisexuality, Mandy, I just wanted to ask you what it's like being with somebody of a different sexual orientation.
Why would it be any different than being in any other relationship?
Well, does it cause any problems with your friends? After all, the lesbian and gay community is notorious for looking down on bisexuals.
Come off it. That's a complete cliché. It's got no grounding.
Well, that's not entirely true.
What do you mean?
Oh, come on, we both know people who feel like that.
Do you? I don't. Who are you talking about? Your mates?
No, just, you know, people I've met over the years.
It's just a minority. It's not really representing the whole gay and lesbian community, is it?
No, but I'm just saying.
Well, I've certainly hit a raw nerve there. That's obviously a little bit of an issue for you both.
Did Nadja Minhas tell you how she got those cuts?
Cut and bread, I think.
She told me she fell on broken glass. And those bruises were more recent than she said.
She's had a lot of injuries recently.
I should have said something. I'm going to check on her.
Missing Freya on the ready.
Freya, do you find it difficult being bisexual?
Well, I mean, with so many people to choose from, it must just be torture. Everyone you meet must be a potential.
do you know what? You're absolutely right. Because I'm attracted to everyone and everything, when I get turned on, that's a real problem because I want to hump the kitchen table.
That's all right.
The washing machine. Right, the radiator is actually quite good.
Thank you.
Listen,
just because I'm bisexual, that doesn't mean that I'm some rampant nymphomaniac, nor does it mean that I am incapable of being monogamous.
Hey, actually, there's a fantastic item on the blog about it. You know, you really should read it. It's on the heading Sex and the Bigot.
Unfortunately, that's all we've got time for, but I'd like to thank my guests, one frank female and her partner, Mandy. It's been a pleasure.
It's a murderer. He's a murderer!
You okay?
He's a murderer!
Are you alright?
Go away!
Something
leave
happened.
Me alone.
Are you okay?
Leave me alone.
Do you want us to call somebody for you?
Leave me alone!
Are you alright? We'll call someone for you, okay?
Leave me
alone. Are you alright?
Leave me alone.
Are you okay?
Go away.
Are you okay?
Hi, it's me. Give me a call back when you get this. All the nannies have been terrible, useless. At this rate, I'm never going to get back to work. I'm just going to end up some demented housewife who stays at home all day baking and watching Jeremy Kyle. My brain is turning to mush, Daniel. What the hell am I going to do? Really, what the hell am I going to do?
Hello?
Please. Help me.
Hello?
Help me.
Nadja, is that you?
Well, I'm taking a year out at the moment.
You're a student?
Well, come on then. Why do you want to be a nanny?
Well, I love children, especially babies.
Really?
But I'm also fascinated with the early stages of child development.
Go on.
Well, the first 5 years are so important.
Absolutely.
That's why parents and caregivers should constantly talk, read, even sing to babies. I mean, even if the child isn't able to understand the words yet, it's still going to help them develop their social and language skills.
So, what other methods would you use to aid development?
Children learn and grow by giving them new and interesting things to look at, listen to, smell, to play with. Stimuli is key.
Nadja, how are you feeling now?
Nadja, talk to me, please. Has someone hurt you?
I was scared. I had to get away.
Get away from who? Those bruises. Did Salim do them? You don't have to put up with it.
Maybe I deserve it.
You don't honestly believe that, do you? Nadra.
I should have protected her.
Who?
Her baby. My beautiful, precious baby.
Hello?
What are you doing back?
Early lunch. I got your message. Sorry you didn't manage to find anyone.
Oh, well, actually, I did, and she's perfect.
Great.
She's exactly what I was looking for.
Well, I can't wait to meet her. Have you arranged for a second interview?
Well, no need. I agreed to trial her.
What?
Well, like I said, she's perfect.
But I told you not to hire anyone till I'd had a chance to vet them.
Well, I didn't think it was necessary. Anyway, it's no big deal.
So my opinion counts for nothing, does it?
Don't get all sulky. She was perfect for the job, so I made the decision.
In case you've forgotten, Joe is actually my son as well.
Now you're overreacting.
Do you know what? This is so typical of you. You never value my opinion.
Where are you going?
They said it was court death.
There's nothing that you could have done. Nadra, you're not to blame.
He is. Ask him.
Who, Salim?
Ask him what happened. She just would not stop crying. He put a pillow over her face.
Nadra, Salim is dead. What happened?
I can't remember. I don't know. I can't remember. Coming towards me. He tried to kill me.
The pillow was over his face.
No. No. I promised my baby I would make him pay.
Nadra, I'm gonna have to call the police.
Thank you for today. I couldn't have done it without you.
You were a star.
Just the photo shoot with Leatherbridge Life to do now.
You're not going to knock that on the head? I mean, it's not important. It's just some trashy gossip piece.
Yeah, even so, I think it'd be fun to do. My public need me.
Oi, you said this morning you were going to concentrate on your work more.
Yeah, and I am. It'll be fine.
Oh, Freya, if you don't put the hours in, you're going to fail again.
It's not going to happen, Mand, OK? It's going to be fine. I'm on a roll.
Josh Reynolds.
well, I seem to have told him you're stuck in a wheelchair.
What have you done?
Isn't that mine?
You can't see her.
You can't get out of the chair. What if Jeremy sees you?
You can't tell me what to do.
No.
I'm not some kid.
No.
And you're not mum.
I am so sorry.
And it's fine. I'm fine.
The day of the fun run.